Hello friends, today we will be studying the functional areas of the cerebral hemisphere. Now, what we see here is a specimen of cerebral hemisphere and let's get oriented. This is the anterior end or the frontal pole. This is the posterior end or the occipital pole and this is the temporal pole. This is the superolateral surface, the medial surface, superior border, superomedial border and the inferior border. So this is the cerebral hemisphere of the left side. Now let us come to identify the major functional areas which we see here. This sulcus which runs in between two parallel running gyri is the central sulcus. So just in front of it, the precentral gyrus is the primary motor area, Brodmann's area number 4. Just in front of it, the posterior parts of the superior frontal gyrus, middle frontal gyrus and some part of the inferior frontal gyrus constitutes the premotor area, Brodmann's area number 6. And this area, that is the central part of the middle frontal gyrus, is the frontal eye field, Brodmann's area number 8. Then we move on to see the secondary motor area which lies on the medial surface. On the medial surface, the point where the central sulcus cuts the superomedial border and reaches the medial surface, the area around it is the paracentral lobule. The gyrus which lies in front of the paracentral lobule is the medial frontal gyrus and that is the secondary motor area. So these four are the motor areas. Now let us go back to the superolateral surface and see the sensory areas. Behind the central sulcus lies the postcentral gyrus and that is the primary sensory area, Brodmann's area number 312. What we see here is the posterior ramus of the lateral sulcus and its upper lip, which is the inferior surface of the inferior frontal gyrus, marks the secondary sensory area. So two sensory areas, primary and secondary sensory areas. Now we move on to see the visual areas. This is the occipital lobe. The point where the calcarine sulcus comes and ends on the occipital pole, that area just near the occipital pole is the primary visual area, area number 17. And just related to this are the secondary visual areas or the visual association areas, area number 18 and area number 19. Visual areas are also seen on the medial surface related to the calcarine sulcus. This is the calcarine sulcus. On either side of the calcarine sulcus is the primary visual area, area number 17. Outer to that is area number 18 on both the sides and then is area number 19 on both the outermost aspects. So 17, 18, 19, 17, 18, 19 on either side of the calcarine sulcus on the medial surface is where we also see the primary and secondary visual areas. Now we will see the auditory areas. Auditory areas are seen along the inferior lip of the posterior ramus of the lateral sulcus. So basically, we need to see the superior surface of the superior temporal gyrus to visualize the auditory areas. So this what we see here, we have taken a horizontal section to get a clearer view of the superior surface of the superior temporal gyrus. So what we see here are two transversely running gyri, the anterior transverse temporal gyrus and the posterior transverse temporal gyrus. This anterior transverse temporal gyrus is the point where we see the primary auditory area or Brodmann's area number 41 and 42. And just behind it,
The posterior transverse temporal gyrus marks the secondary auditory area or the auditory association area, which is Brodmann's area number 22. Now we will see the speech areas. Speech areas are seen in the dominant hemisphere, and since most of us are right-handed, the left cerebral hemisphere is the dominant hemisphere. What we see here is the left cerebral hemisphere itself. Now speech areas are the sensory speech areas and the motor speech areas. Now what we see here are the motor speech areas. This is the Sylvian point, and from here we see the anterior horizontal and the anterior ascending rami and the posterior ramus of the lateral sulcus. So this triangular gyrus here is the pars triangularis, and this one behind it is the pars opercularis. These two constitute the motor speech areas. Brodmann area number 45 and 44. Whereas the sensory speech areas are related to the point where the posterior ramus of lateral sulcus ends. The gyrus around it is the supramarginal gyrus. Whereas the point where the superior temporal sulcus ends is the angular gyrus seen there. So supramarginal gyrus and angular gyrus are the areas for the Wernicke's sensory speech areas, area number 40 and area number 39. So these are the speech areas, motor speech area and the sensory speech area, seen only in the dominant hemisphere, which is the left cerebral hemisphere in most of us who are right-handed.
So that is how we have seen the functional areas of the cerebrum. We saw the motor areas, the sensory areas, the visual areas, auditory areas, and specifically the areas of speech which lie in the dominant hemisphere. Thank you.